Hello and welcome to my channel. In this tutorial, I would like to show you how I created this
animation.
Let's see the preview of what we are going to create today. Open up After Effects and create a new composition. Name the composition as title. I am choosing a 1920 by 1080 composition with a frame rate of 30 and a duration of 2 seconds. Create a new solid layer. Select a white background. Create a new text layer and type in your text. Align the font to the center of the composition. Align the anchor point to the center of the text layer. Now go to the effects and presets panel and search for gradient ramp effect and apply it into the text layer. Choose the colors of your choice. Go to the effects and presets panel and search for drop shadow effect and apply it into the text layer. Set the softness to 25 and distance to 15. Go to the effects and presets panel and search for bevel alpha effect and apply it into the text layer. Open the text layer in the timeline and click on animate and select tracking. At 1 second mark, create a keyframe for track amount with 0 value. And at the start of the timeline, set the tracking amount to 150. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now ramp preview this. Create a keyframe for scale property at 1 second mark. Go to the start of the timeline. Set the scale value to 150. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now ramp preview this. Create a new text layer and type in the same text. Align the text to the center of the composition. Change the color of the text to white. Search for bevel alpha effect and apply it into the second text layer. Search for drop shadow effect and apply it into the second text layer. Set the distance to 10 and softness to 25. Open the second text layer and click on animate and select tracking. At 1 second mark, create a keyframe for tracking amount with 0 value. At the start of the timeline, change the tracking amount to 150. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Click on animate once again and choose the property scale. Set the scale value to 50%. In the range selector 1, go to 15 frames mark and set the start value to 100% and create a keyframe. At the start of the timeline, set the start value to 0. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open up graph editor and change the graph as shown. Click on the advanced settings and set the base tone property to birds. In the animator 2, click on add and select the property position. Set the position value to something to the center of the first text. Go to the animator 2 and click on add and select the property opacity. At 15 frames mark, set the opacity value to 100%. At the start of the timeline, set the opacity value to 0%. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easily ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Reduce the duration between the opacity keyframes. Change the two text layers to 3D. Create a new camera. Create a new null object. Change the null layer to 3D. Parent the camera to null one layer. Bring up the position property. At once again mark, create a keyframe for position. At 20 frames mark, set the Z value to 1000. And at the start of the timeline, set the Z value to 2000. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easily ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. I would like to increase the size of the first text layer. So I am increasing the font size and repositioning it to the center. Also, I am increasing the size of the second text layer and repositioning it to the center. Set the background color to gray, light gray color, to differentiate from the text layer. That's it. Hope you like the video. Let's see the output once again. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as I post the videos. Click on the like button and share it with your friends. Comment down if you have anything to ask. And once again, thanks for being here and supporting me. This is Raudran signing off.